Okay, let's do it.
Stand by, everyone.
Great to you, Wolf.
Wrong DJ one, track go.
This was a huge earthquake, one of the top five or six in the last century. It broke from the epicenter here, hundreds of miles along the coast of Chile. This map shows in orange colors the very strongly shaken areas where the shaking was strong enough to damage structures, and then the weaker shaking in these softer colors off here. Now, one of the reasons that Chile was buffered from this earthquake is the fact that it was a little bit off the coast and a little bit deeper. But the shaking was still quite strong. Had Chile had a vulnerable infrastructure, the devastation would have been far worse. Chile has a modern infrastructure, good building codes,
right,
and so they were relatively protected.
And conversely, the epicenter in Haiti was basically right underneath Port-au-Prince.
That's right. The Enriquillo Fault that runs right past Port-au-Prince created a magnitude 7 earthquake about the same size as that struck the San Francisco area in 1989 during the World Series.
Right.
But in this case, it was a direct hit. It was a bullseye hit on Port-au-Prince, a very vulnerable city without modern codes. And as a consequence, so many buildings came down, so many people died.
We're going to go over here to this map, Wolf. We're going to show you basically the tectonic zones around the world here. And what a lot of people are asking, Mike, is that earthquake in Japan on Friday the 26th, which was less than 24 hours before the one in Chile, this was about a 7.0 that didn't do too much damage. But people are asking, is there a connection? Could this one have triggered the one in Chile?
We don't know that there is a connection. We don't believe so. The Pacific Ring of Fire produces earthquakes and volcanoes all the way around this area. This is where the plates of the Earth are interacting, sliding and grinding past each other. And it causes magnitude 7 earthquakes, maybe a dozen a year or more, and occasional magnitude 8 or even 9 earthquakes. Each one of those causes shaking that spreads over the Earth, but there's really no understanding scientifically about the relationship between a moderate magnitude earthquake in Japan and something that happens thousands of miles away. This map shows the seismic hazard zones of the United States. The colors of this map are those areas that have a particular seismic hazard. This is a map that the USGS produces, and it goes into creating the building codes. So where we have the higher seismic hazards, we have the stronger building codes. And we have, as you can see, there's a zone of hazard, the red colors that run right up the west coast of the United States all the way to the Canadian border. We actually have our own Chilean earthquake or Sumatra earthquake lurking off the coast. There's a zone from about Northern California past Oregon, Washington, up into British Columbia that is a subduction zone. It's where the plates are colliding together as they are off the west coast of South America. And there's the potential for an 8, 8.5, or even a magnitude 9 earthquake there that would cause substantial shaking and a tsunami. And so, of course, in that part of the country, we need to be preparing for large amounts of shaking and preparing the coast to be able to warn the citizens in case there would be a wave coming at some point in the future.
I noticed, though, Mike, that's not just the West Coast that's got some danger areas.
That's right. There's actually seismic hazard in probably about 39 of the states. About 75 million Americans are at risk for seismic shaking. There's one zone that's of particular interest right now. We're coming up on the 200th anniversary of the New Madrid seismic zone sequence. Back in the winter of 1811 and 1812, there was a series of several magnitude 7 or greater earthquakes along the Mississippi in the area of Memphis. These earthquakes, it caused substantial shaking of the land and the sparse population at the time. And if those earthquakes were to occur again today, as we expect that they will someday, they'll cause a substantial shaking for a broad swath of the country that now includes the cities of Memphis, St. Louis, Evansville, and so forth. So this is an area of particular concern. We want to make sure that our buildings are safe, that our citizens are prepared throughout the country, wherever we have this earthquake, wherever you have the earthquake hazard, and make sure that people are prepared and that the buildings don't fall down